అస్మత్ గురుభ్యో నమః, అస్మత్ సర్వగురుభ్యో నమః, అస్మత్ పరమ గురుభ్యో నమః. శ్రీమదే శ్రీ లక్ష్మీ నృసింహ పరబ్రహ్మణే నమః. శ్రీమదే శ్రీ ఆదివంశడగో వీరేంద్ర మహాదేశిఘాయ నమః. శ్రీమదే శివంశడగో శ్రీ వేదాంత దేశికేంద్ర మహాదేశిఘాయ నమః. శ్రీమదే శ్రీ లక్ష్మీ నృసింహ దివ్య పాదుగా సేవక శ్రీవంశడగో శ్రీ నారాయణేంద్ర మహాదేశిఘాయ నమః. శ్రీమదే శివన్ సడగోబ శ్రీ రంగనాథేంద్ర మహాదేశిగాయ నమః. శ్రీమాన్ వెంకటనాథార్య కవిదార్కిక కేసరి
వేదాంతాచార్యవర్యో మే సన్నిధత్తాం సదా హృది
జ్ఞానానందమయం దేవం నిర్మలస్ఫటికాకృతిం
ఆధారం సర్వవిద్యానాం హయగ్రీవముపాస్మహే.
వందే బృందావనచరం వల్లవీజనవల్లభం
జయంతి సంభవం దామ వైజయంతి విభూషణం
నిగమకల్పదరోర్కళితం ఫలం శుగముఖాదమృతద్రవ సంయుధం పిబద భాగవతం రసమాలయం ముహురహో రసికాభువి భావుగాహం కృష్ణాయ వాసుదేవాయ దేవకీ నందనాయ చ నందగోపకుమారాయ గోవిందాయ నమో నమః. నమః పంకజనాభాయ, నమః పంకజమాలినే, నమః పంకజనేత్రాయ, నమస్తే పంకజాంగ్రయే. వేదత్தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழுமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார் களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமயிலை திருவல்லிக்கேணி கண்டேனே. வசுதேவ சுதம் தேவம் கம்சசாணூரமர்தனம் தேவகி பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும். தொட்ட படையட்டும் தோலாத வென்றியான் அட்டபுயகரத்தான ஞான்று குட்டத்து கோள் முதலை துஞ்ச குறித்தெரிந்த சக்கரத்தான் தாழ் முதலே நங்கட்கு சார்வு. நாராயணா ஓ மணிவண்ணா நாகணையாய் வாராய் என் ஆரிடை நீக்காய். கிராகிரஸ்தே கஜேந்திரர் உபரி சரபசம் தாட்சமாருஹ்ய தாவன் வியாகூர்ணன் மால்யபூஷ வசன பரிகரோ மேக கம்பீர கோஷக நக்ராக்ராந்தே கரீந்திரே முகுளித நயனே மூலமூலேதி கிண்ணே நாஹம் நாஹம் ந ஜாகம் ந ச பவதி புனஸ் தாத்ருஷோ மாத்ருஷேஷு.
இத்யேவம் த்யக்த ஹஸ்தே சபதி சுரகணே பாவ சூன்யே சமஸ்தே மூலம் யத் ப்ராதாசீத் சதிஷது பகவான் மங்களம் சந்ததம் நஹ.
ப்ராதஸ்மராமி பவபீதி மகார்த்தி சாந்தியை நாராயணம் கருடவாகனமஞ்சனாபம்
விபூதமதவாரண முக்திஹேதும் சக்ராயுதம் கருணவாரிஜபத்ரநேத்ர.
ப்ராதர் நமாமி மனசா வசசா ச மூர்த்னா பாதாரவிந்தயுகளம் பரமஸ்ய பும்சஹ.
நாராயணஸ்ய நரகார்ணவதாரணஸ்ய பாராயண பிரவண விப்ரபராயணஸ்ய.
ப்ராதர் பஜாமி பஜதாம் அபயங்கரம் தம் ప్రాక్ సర్వ జన్మ కృత పాప భయ పనుత్యై.
యోగ్రాహ వక్త్ర పతితాంగ్రి గజేంద్ర ఘోర శోక ప్రణాశన కరో ధృత శంఖ చక్రః.
లోగత్రయమిదం పుణ్యం ప్రాదరుత్తాయ పడేత్.
లోగత్రయ గురు తస్మై తత్యాత్ ఆత్మ పదం హరిః.
టుడేస్ లెక్చర్ 38. And this will be the last one, somewhere other thattu thadimari vilundadichine, somewhere we are coming to the last class. Try to finish this one after a long time. Like the Gajendran was suffering, we also took a long time to finish this one. We started about 2.5 years back and there was a gap, and then we come back and everything is good because we come later, we know more about the Ragasetra Saram, Sri Bhashyam and everything, and so we can able to link to all those kinds of things. Primarily we understood the DBJ. Without that one, we cannot understand any of our literature. So this will be the last class in the Gajendra Moksham series. The last 37 class in the Gajendra Moksham, we started from where Gajendra was very happily roaming around the forest, got into the trouble, and the crocodile clutched his feet and he was grabbing that one. He was fighting for about 1,000 years. He could not do anything. Then he made this story to the Bhagavan. How Bhagavan came down and how he rescued and released him and everything. And also, what were the sabams? Why he was born as an elephant? Why the crocodile was there? And how the saba vimochanam and everything we saw. So that is what the whole story we have seen, that one. So at the end of the last class, we concluded with the last phrase, Garuda Asana Agat Swabhavanam. Garuda Asana Agat Swabhavanam. So sitting on top of the Garudan, Vedatma Vigageshwaro, Bhagavan returned to his Swasthanam. So he is returned to his own resident. That ends the Gajendra Moksham kind of a thing. So this would be, now if it is ended, then what we are going to do now, if you are asking. So this is very similar to think of that if we go for a drama or a music performance or anything. So what happens is at the end, they'll end of the show, they put the curtain. And then the host comes back and says, look here, they have done everything, great job, and then curtain goes, and then they come back and take all the applause and the standing ovation. That is what Bhagavan will be doing. That is what Sukha Brahmam is going to do. So it is over. Now, they are not actors. Okay? Acting is done. Now they receive as a person who did that job. Okay? So now, Bhagavan came as a rescue of that is done. Now, Parabrahmam, Bhagavan is going to be talking from that view. And Sukha Brahmam, who told that one as a host, now let's all give a big hand for this Hari. So he's going to say like that one. And that is what this part we're going to be seeing today. Sukha Brahmam is continuing because he was telling previously, this is how Bhagavan went to Swasthanam. So Swabhavanam, he went on that one. Then he's continuing. We did up to 13 slogas or so. The rest of the 13 slogas we will do today. Yedan Maharaja Taveridho Mayam Krishnanubhavo Gajaraja Mokshanam Swargyam Yasasyam Kalikalmashabaham Dussopananasanam Guruvarya Shrunvadham. Beautiful. Maharaja. Anytime it is not the Acharya and Sishya or a teacher and a student, we always have to give the proper respect. Proper respect, especially when you are sitting in the Sri Bhashyam Kalakshepam or Ragasatra Kalakshepam, when people ask question, hey, nobody says like that. Swami, let me answer you. The Bhagavadas who are listening the Sri Bhashyam, or for that matter, any of the Kalakshepam, all the what we talk, Gandharas, Dushtayam, all the four of them. So, when they listen that one, you have to give proper respect. Same thing with the Maitreya and Parashara. We saw that one in the Sri Vishnu Puranam. So, here Maharaja, later on he is going to pay respects to him and then tell. So, because he is sitting down listening, doesn't mean he is low. Everybody is intelligent, you know. Maharaja, O King Parikshit. That's what it says. Tava irida maya yedadu. To you. Irida, described, maya, by me, yedadu, this. Parichet, so far, I have explained to you all the things about this Gajendra Moksham. So, this is as explained by me to you. Krishna అనుభావో గజరాజ మోక్షణం. కృష్ణ, సీ లుక్ అట్ దట్ వన్, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఆర్ డన్ బై సంబడి, ది క్రెడిట్ ఆల్వేస్ గోస్ టు కృష్ణ. సో కృష్ణ, ది ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ది లార్డ్ కృష్ణ, భగవాన్ కృష్ణాస్ లీల, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ గజరాజ మోక్షణం. వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. కృష్ణానుభావో గజరాజ మోక్షణం. కృష్ణ డిడ్ దిస్ వన్ యాజ్ ఎ లీలా. ఓకే, లోకవత్ లీల కైవల్యం. వై హీ డస్ దట్ వన్? ఫర్ హిస్ ఓన్ ప్లెషర్. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈ సేయింగ్. సో ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ కృష్ణ, డెలివరింగ్ ది మోక్షం ఆఫ్ గజేంద్ర. బట్ వెన్ భగవాన్ ఎంజాయ్స్, శేషి ఉగంత కైంకర్యం, వి ఆల్సో ఫీల్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ. వి ఆర్ నాట్ ప్రైమరీ వన్, ఈజ్ ది ప్రైమరీ వన్. బట్ వెన్ వీ లుక్ అట్ హిమ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ రిఫ్లెక్టెడ్ ఆన్ అస్. దట్ ఈస్ హౌ వి గెట్. సో భగవాన్, యూ కెన్ కాల్ నారాయణ, అఖిల గురో, ఫైనలీ ఇట్ ఆల్ ఎండ్స్ అప్ విత్ లార్డ్ కృష్ణ ఓన్లీ. సో అఫ్ కోర్స్ వ్యాస భగవాన్, వెన్ వీ రోడ్ దట్ వన్, హీ వాస్ అట్ ది సేమ్ టైమ్ విత్ ది లార్డ్ కృష్ణ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో వెన్ భీష్మ టోల్డ్ దిస్ విష్ణు సహస్రనామం అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వాస్ క్యాప్చర్డ్ ఇన్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వ్యాస భగవాన్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఆల్ ది గౌరవ పాండవాస్ అండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఆర్ ది డిసెండెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది వ్యాస భగవాన్ ఓన్లీ. సో స్వర్గ్యం యశస్యం కలికల్మష అభహం. స్వర్గ్యం మీన్స్ స్వర్గం, యశస్యం, యశస్యం మీన్స్ ఫేమ్, ప్రైజ్. కలికల్మష, కలికల్మష ఇన్ ది కలియుగం దర్ ఆర్ సో మెనీ సిన్స్ వీ డూ అపహం, సో ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ విల్ బి రిమూవ్డ్. సో వెరీ పర్టికులర్లీ దే సే అబౌట్ ది కలియుగం, బికాస్ ఆల్ అదర్ యుగం పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ సమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ది మారల్ క్యారెక్టర్స్. పీపుల్ హ్యాడ్ ది ధ్యానం అండ్ ది వేదం అండ్ ది యాగం అండ్ దెన్ ది భగవాన్ అవతారం అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దే సీమ్స్ టు బి గుడ్. ఇన్ ది కలి ఇస్ ది మోస్ట్ డిఫికల్ట్ వన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వై ఇన్ ది కలి ఈవెన్ ది భగవత్ స్మరణ ఇస్ గుడ్, బికాస్ యూ క్యాంట్ ఈవెన్ డూ దట్. దట్ ఈస్ రీజన్ దే బ్రాట్ డౌన్ ది స్టాండర్డ్ సో లో. యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ఆల్ దిస్ యాగం, జస్ట్ థింక్ అబౌట్ భగవాన్. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ భగవాన్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ విల్ టెల్. దుస్వప్న నాశనం, ఎరాడికేటింగ్ ది కాజ్ ఆఫ్ ది బ్యాడ్ డ్రీమ్స్. ఓకే, ది డ్రీమ్స్, ఈవెన్ స్వామి దేశికన్ ఆల్సో సేస్ దట్ వన్. సమ్టైమ్స్ వెన్ యూ లుక్ అట్ ది డ్రీమ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ది జ్యోతిషం అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దట్ forecast certain things, one should not be afraid of that. So if you get a durswapanam, swapanam is not under your control. We saw that one in Sri Bhashyam, only Bhagavan controls the swapanam. And the same thing, the grahas, they are doing some kind of a good or bad to you, that you cannot control, but you can mitigate them. Okay, so that is why durswapananasam. So what you do is you do everything to the Perumal. Whatever it has to happen, instead of your real life it happens, it may happen in tomorrow's swapanam. So that is why duswapana nasanam. Guru varya, kuru varya, shunvadam. Kuru, Gauravas, Kuru dynasty. That is why Abhimanyu son Parikshit. Abhimanyu and Uttare son is Parikshit. So he says, my dear king Parikshit, who is coming from the Kuru dynasty, I had to tell you, so far all the things what I told you, it is all the great leelas of Krishna. Krishna, that is one of the things we have to remember. Everything you talk, at the end it comes to Krishna. How Bhagavan displayed with his own compassion. Two things we understand in this. One, compassion. Second, anukampa, that's right. Second, power. Okay? What the compassion tells you basically is easy accessibility, sausilyam and saulabhyam, all those kinds of thing. And when you go vasalyam, sausilyam, saulabhyam, power tells you the paratvam. Okay, that is what he says over here. These only two things it tells. Power means everything you can think of. Gajendra cannot pull and Bhagavan came and pulled all of them, including the crocodile, or Brahma, Shiva and none of them can do, but he did all of them. So it is the power. So if you hear this story, you will be blessed with plenty of things, including swargam, fame, no bad dreams, the effect of bad dreams and everything. More importantly, you will become a Uttama Bhakta, Uttama Bhagavata. You will not be affected by the sins of the Kali Yugam. You never encounter any more bad dreams. That is what he was saying in this one. That is the Shugha Brahmam telling about the Palashruti, first one. He continues the Palashruti over here and he tells now, when it is the best time to think about the Gajendra Moksham? Yada anukirtyandi etate shreyaskama dvijadaya suchaya prada uttaya dusvapanadi ubashantye yada anukirtyandi etate. Thus, anukirtyandi means chanting when you are doing that. Yata, that is very important. Yada means what? As it was told by him. That is very important because without any deviation. Okay. This is very important because some of the Bhagavatam books, if you take that one, Bhagavan, Arina and Atle Devdana, Bhagavan Age, Parameshwaran Age, Sivanaki, Arina Yedirk. Okay. So, Yatha means what I told you. I didn't tell about Shiva here. Krishna, look at that word, okay, Krishna, there's a particular reason why it is told Krishna over there, because you should not go and massage the things, what is given, okay, so same thing, when we talk to Nirvisesham, okay, when you say that one, there is no Visheshana, no Gunas, you cannot assume that one, Swaroopa, Roopa, Guna, Vibhuti, everything Bhagavan has got all of them, that is why Yatha means, thus, without any deviation, anukirtyandi, chanting, yetadu, this Gajendra Moksham, Shreyas Kama Dijadayaha. Shreyas Kama, those who desire auspiciousness. Shreyas means good things, great things. Dvijadayaha, Dvijadayaha means twice born. Twice born means who are had this Brahmanas in general. Usually, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, anybody who put the punal. So, Yajyobavidam. So, Suchaya Pradaha Uttaya. Suchaya means usually Suddham. Suchi means Suddham. Suchaya means in their life Brahmanas. Even though it is applicable to all the three, the most important for Brahmana is the Acharam. Acharam is the Suddhi. All others, they may follow, they may not follow. For Brahmin, it is always important. Anywhere you see the Brahmin, he always carries a sumbu with him. He always keep on washing his hand. Okay? So, always doing the achamanam and everything. Suchaya, oh, for the Brahmanas, Prada Uttaya. The morning after waking up. After waking up, you should do that one. So, there may be a question here. Suchaya, when he said that one, that means when you have to think about Gajendra Moksham, Adimba. So usually, if you look at through Bhagavadam, you have to get down, brush your teeth and everything, and then your Suddhi, then only you can tell that one. But Gajendra Moksham does not ask the kind of requirements like the Ashtakshara. Okay? Even Gajendra was doing with all these kinds of bleeding and everything, at that time he was crying for that. We are listening. So by the time you get down and go for this bath and go for your brushing the teeth, you don't know how long you may live. It's better to think about it. So that is the reason they say as soon as you get up, you can think of that one, Gajendra Moksham. They made it a little easier for us. So you don't need to brush or anything. Thinking of that, that's nothing. Nothing will stop that. Duswapana nadi upashantaye. Duswapanadi. Upashantaye means it will eradicate all type of troubles starting from Duswapanam. Duswapanam is the first and all other problems and everything. So, Vedas and other Pramanas, what we learn here, we have to learn it in the proper way. That is what he says over here. Yatha, that first word is very important over here. whether you learn Srimad Bhagavadam, Bhagavad Gita, Sribhashyam, Alvar Arulichayal, Yadha Anukirtyandi. That means you have to do in such a way, don't start twisting and turning all of them, and Kutrishti, don't do all those kinds of things. Desigan very carefully told in Srimad Ragasyatra Saram, Takya Pandiyattale Yadayum Sadikka Vallavaragayalum Nam Pramana Saranamagave Pondom. With argument, you can prove anything you want. Who said sun is coming on east? You can say west. Who said there is a sun? There's no sun. You can prove anything with a debate, but that doesn't mean anything. Where is the Pramanam? Can you show our elders have done this one? Can you show our Acharyas, Gurus and Alvars and everything up to the Vedas? Is there any quote is there? So that is why it is called Pramanam. So you have to tell everything with the Pramanam. Otherwise, it is useless. So here, the Pramana says something. Sastram and Sampradayam. Sastram basically tells Veda, Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Puranam. But how do you interpret them? Like when we take the book and look at that one, it says Nirvisesham. Oh, Nirvisesham means it does not have anything. We will interpret like that. That is why you have to learn Sribhashyam. They ask, why, I don't know where we mentioned that one in Sribhashyam class, why Imbarmana, when he said, these are the things you should do at the Andhimadasai. First one, Sribhashyate Paditthi Pravarpittal. Then Arulichayalai. Oh, Imbarmana are very selfish. He says his book first before Alvars. Is that so? That is, they can ask all these things. And our Acharyas asked that one. No. Our Alvars have done good. But it is more funneled by Imbarmana. So you understand our Sampradayam correctly so that you can go to the Alvar. Muniye. Nan Mugane Mukkannappa. I was listening to something and that says even Alvars are singing about Shiva. It is not. It is Andaryami. How do you know the Andaryami? Unless you study Sribhashyam. Okay? That is the reason why you have to go through Sampradayam. Sampradayam tells this is how the Sastras are interpreted by your Acharya, your lineage. For example, Sri Jayanti is done by some day, Sri Jayanti is done by some other day. Both of them are Sri Vaishnavas. Why? Because their Sampradayam does that one. So that is very important. That is why very carefully Vyasa Bhagavan put it over here. Yatha Anukirtyanti. Listen to your Acharya. Sir, can I go and read the Gita? So can woman read the Gita? Ramayanam, can woman tell that one? Ramayanam, woman can read the Sundara Gandam. Woman can say the Vedas. Woman can say the Gayatri Mantram. Don't ask. Go and ask your Acharya. Whatever he says, do that one. Because there are so many variations because it's come through millions of years. So we have to take the string, what it does. So first, Melayar Sivana Vintuvana Kettiyel, Andar says, follow your elders. Follow your father, grandfather, Periyappa, Siddhappa, whatever they did, follow that. Then your Acharya thing. Then Sastras. Don't go to the Sastras because you cannot interpret directly, correctly. That is why Yatha, that is the word he has put very carefully there. So this Gajendra Moksham has to be told exactly by those understand Sribhashyam and Ragasyatra Saram and everything, how do they interpret the word called Bhagavan? That is why we spent a lot of time to go into Vishnu Puranam to connect to that one. Because Vishnu Puranam, Parasara Rishi is telling Vyasa Bhagavan, this is how you have to write the Brahma Sutra. Okay? That kind of a thing we are going. So we had to go through that way. That is the only way you can understand. So you had to have a Sampradaya Parishuddhi, Desigan said. Chain. So, we get bad dreams. Why do you get bad dreams? Because of your sinful actions. Okay? Bhagavan wants to punish you. That is why he gives you that one. Therefore, Dussopanam, when you say that one, bad dreams equals effect of your Pabham. That is what? That is minimized effect of your Pabham. So, you can think of that one like a పాపారంభక పాపం. యు గాన్ త్రూ దట్ వన్, ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ డూ ఎనీథింగ్ టు యూ. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ యూ వాంట్స్ టు సే ఓవర్ హియర్. సో ఎనీ దుస్వప్నం అట్ దట్ టైమ్ యూ వుడ్ హ్యావ్ హ్యాడ్ ది ఎఫెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ దట్. లెట్ సే దర్స్ ఎ లయన్ ఆర్ ఎ టైగర్ ఈస్ చేసింగ్ యూ, ఆల్ యువర్ బాడీ ఈస్ పర్స్పైరింగ్, యూ విల్ బి బ్రీతింగ్ హార్డ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ హెస్ హ్యాపెండ్. యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ది కాన్షియన్స్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్, బట్ ఇట్స్ హ్యాపెన్ ఫిజికలీ టు యువర్ బాడీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఐ కాల్ దుఃఖారంభక భావం. Because you had that one, something is going to come later. No, it is not. It is done. It's gone. Throw it out. So, Bhagavan, Swapanatla kudukarade vande, it is vande, Rajagumanaku kudutta lagudhandane bole. That is what it is. So, you don't have to worry too much about that one. Same thing with the good also. Bhagavan comes in the Swapanam, you had a beautiful sakshatkaram. There's nothing you can do. That's all you get. For a small thing, you did a good thing, I give you. If it had done a large thing, I would have given, like a bhakti yogam. But you don't deserve. Okay? Both of them is only done that way. So, and then continue. Idamaha harihi prido gajendram guru sattama shunvadam sarvabhudhanam sarvabhudamayo vibhu. Every time when he gets a chance, what he does one? All the living things, who is inside there? All the living things, who they listen to? All the living things, how they are operated and controlled? That is what he says. So, after learning all these things, and then go, don't go to the Devadhantaram. That is what he was trying to tell. So, in the morning when you think of the Gajendra Moksham, immediately the whole day would be nice, you would be channelized to be a true Prabhannan. Anyadevada Paratva Buddhi will be removed only if you listen to the Gajendra Moksham. So the day starts from there. And then only you can go into all those kinds of Abhigamana Aradhanam and everything later going to do. So Guru Sattama, Kuru Sattama, he says, a Kuru dynasty you are there. Idam Aha Arihi Prido Gajendram. Idam, this, Aha, that is told. Arihi, Hari. This Hari is told. What is going to tell later on? Whatever you're going to listen now, it is told by Hari. Prido Gajendram. Prido, you can put it everywhere because his name itself is Mal. Mal in Tamil means affection, love. ప్రీదో గజేంద్రన్, ప్రీదో సర్వభూతానాం. ఓకే, ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో ఈస్ వెరీ లవింగ్ అండ్ అఫెక్షనేట్, వెరీ ప్లీజ్డ్, అండ్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు టెల్ టు గజేంద్రన్. హూ ఈస్ హీ? సర్వభూతమయో విభు. ఆల్ ది రగశత్ర సారం యూ స్టడీడ్ అండ్ యూ టెల్ ది డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఎ జీవాత్మ అండ్ ఎ పరమాత్మ అండ్ అచేతనం. Achetanam does not have any knowledge, throw it out. But I also have knowledge, Bhagavan also has knowledge. Why I cannot call as a Bhagavan? For example, if somebody argues like that, then you say, you are Anu. He is Vibhu. He is Vibhu. That one word takes care of everything. Where Swami Desikan get that one? From here. Sarvabhudamayo Vibhu. Whenever there's a sabdam Vibhu comes, it refers only to him, nobody else. If at all it refers to somebody, it is blessed by him only. See, when we say Prabhatti Sonishtai, you cannot do Sonishtai. How can you do Sonishtai? Sonishtai will happen only if your Acharya does everything to you and then say, you have done very good, you are a very smart student and everything. With my blessing and with my permission, you can go ahead and do. I can stand. You do directly to Perumal. He gives you permission. So, that is how Emperumanar got, Emperumanar did the Sharanagati. Nobody can directly do. Without Acharya, you cannot do. There is no Prabhatti without Acharya. Sunishtai, Uktinishtai and Bhagavadeva. Acharya Nishtai and Bhagavad Nishtai, all the four, when you take that one. So Acharya has to be there. See, when you come here, Prido Gajendram, when we say that one, Bhagavan is pleased. If he is not pleased, pralayam is going to happen. Okay? I gave all the shariram and everything, you are not doing. Because of his pleas, he is going to try to tell everything. Shunvadam sarvabhudanam. In the presence of everything, it is. Of course, he is present everywhere. Everything is present there. So he says, that's why that Vibhu padam is very, very important. Kuru dynasty, eh? In that lineage you have come, Bhagavan Hari, who is the super soul, who is Antaratma, who is holding and who is inside also, Narayana padam. So he is very pleased after the Gajendra moksham. And he is addressing to the Gajendra. Watch that one. The way he says that one, Gajendra. Bhagavan says as the Anga, a Raja, Indradyumna. Okay? So, he talks only from the Gajendran viewpoint. Bhagavan talks, I know. Just like Arjuna, he says, Bahunime Vididhani, Tavasarjuna, he says, so many Janmas have happened, you don't know. I know my Janmas and your Janmas. So, Ademari in that, Bhagavan will tell Anga, but he will tell only Gajendra. That is what he will say. So, he is saying that one, Bhagavan is addressing over here for everybody. That is very important. So, this Gajendra Moksham is not only for humans or animals or one kind of a caste or one kind of a nationality or one kind of a gender or no. Everybody can hear and they can benefit out of that. So, that ends with the Shuga Brahmam's Palashruti. Now he is going to introduce. Okay, we all watched this music performance. Today the main person, the Kadanayagan, who is going to be that one? Bhagavan is going to introduce that. Idam agarihi prido gajendram guru sattamaha shunvadam sarvabhudanam sarvabhudamayo vibhu. That is what we told right now. So, he introduced the Bhagavan. Who is this Bhagavan? Vibhu, loving, for everybody he says, and what he says is going to be really great. Please listen. So then he gave it to them. Now Bhagavan is going to come. And Bhagavan, he has already went on the Garudan. Now he is coming back. The curtain lifts up. And why? Because he wants to take the applause from everybody. So in the drama, it is applause wants to everybody. Here it is not. Here, remember, this is what I have done. I am coming and telling you why it is important. None of the avataram is like that. None of the avataram is like, did Rama come back and say, remember how I did that one? This is Agalya Sapam. This is Ramana took that one. This is what I did. This is what you learn. Never did that one. Krishna did? No. Narasimha did? No. None of the avataram. Only this avataram. See, Bhagavan Uvacha. But the Bhagavan makes himself very, very low in this one. Not like Krishna given the Uddhava Gita. There are also seven slogas Krishna gave. All the seven chapters of the Veda, he gave that one. But very, very tough one you have to follow. But here, he gave a very simple one. Why? Because Uddhava, I am telling you, you are a jnani. And you are like a noble laureate. For you, I had to give at a higher level. Here, we are not talking about a human. We are talking about an animal. If I can rescue an animal, what is the minimum you have to do? How beautifully Bhagavan. Bhagavan brings everything so low and he says, just think, I'll give you moksha. See, Bhagavan vacha, ye mam tvam. Saras chedasam, what he says, so many things he is going to say. Saras cha idam. Those who think of me, first thing he says, ye mam tvam, those who think of themselves. First, you go into Artha Panchakam, in that one, Bhagavan therinjikano, jeevana therinjikano. Bhagavat Swarupam, Jeeva Swarupam. That is what first thing he mentioned. Understand me, understand you. ఓకే. సో ఫర్ ఎలఫెంట్ ఆల్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ టు నో, ఆల్ ఇట్ డస్ నో ఐఎమ్ యూస్లెస్, సంబడి ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు హెల్ప్. యు హ్యావ్ స్టడీడ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అండ్ యు నో ఆఫ్టర్ స్టడీయింగ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఐ కమ్ టు ది కన్క్లూషన్ ఐ కెనాట్ డూ ఎనీథింగ్, యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డూ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. అండ్ దెన్ దిస్ లేక్ సరస్, బికాస్ దట్ ఈస్ యు వన్ రిమైండ్స్ యూ ఆఫ్ ది దిస్ గజేంద్ర మోక్షం. బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ స్టార్ట్స్ విత్ అండ్ దెన్ గిరి కందర కానగం, హిల్స్ కేవ్స్ అండ్ ది ఫారెస్ట్. సో హిల్స్ మీన్స్ త్రికూడ మౌంటైన్, దే వి సా దట్ వన్ అండ్ ఆల్ ది కేవ్స్ ఇన్ సైడ్ అండ్ ది ఫారెస్ట్. అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ టోల్డ్ బై భగవాన్. హూ ఇస్ దిస్ భగవాన్ ఇస్ అ క్వశ్చన్ వెల్కమ్. భగవాన్ ఆల్వేస్ హ్యావ్ టు హ్యావ్ సమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఫేవరెటిజం. ది ఫేవరెటిజం ఈస్ టు కృష్ణ. కృష్ణ ఆఫ్టర్ హి సేస్ యూ, ఆఫ్టర్ హి సేస్ మీ, యూ అండ్ దిస్ తడాగం, అండ్ దెన్ హి సేస్ దిస్ మౌంటైన్ అండ్ దిస్ ఫారెస్ట్ గార్డెన్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దట్ ప్లేస్. ఆఫ్టర్ వాట్ హీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు టే, ది ఫస్ట్ వన్ హీ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు సే ది బ్యాంబూ, వేణు. కృష్ణ లవ్స్ దట్ వన్ వేణు. హీ సేస్ వేణు, లుక్ అట్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్, బిఫోర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఎల్స్ హీ సేస్. అదనాల కృష్ణనుడియ వేణు, దట్స్ వేణుగోపాల్ అండ్ వి కాల్, దట్ ఈస్ ది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. హీ లవ్స్ దట్ వన్ కృష్ణ అండ్ ఆల్ ది భక్తాస్, ఆల్ దిస్ గోపికా స్త్రీస్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. అండ్ ప్రియాడ్ వారు పుట్టు వన్ పదిగం, హీ సేస్ వన్ కృష్ణ డస్ దట్ వన్ ది హోల్ వరల్డ్ హోల్ యూనివర్స్ స్టాప్డ్. నారద డిడ్ నాట్ డూ, తుంబురు డిడ్ నాట్ డూ అండ్ మేనగా అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి డిడ్ నాట్ డ్యాన్స్. వి కెనాట్ డ్యాన్స్ ఫర్ దిస్ మ్యూజిక్. సచ్ అ గ్రేట్ వన్ కృష్ణ, only you can do. That is it. So Krishna is very favorite of that Venu. Somewhere or other he introduces that one. Even though he is a Narayanan, he says he is a Krishna. Okay, very beautiful that one. Because he could have put Krishna Gopalan, he could have put the cow, or he could have done that one. But the first thing what we hear is Shruti. Kwanega modalle kadala dan keku. అప్పుడు కన్నాల పాకు. సో దట్ ఈస్ యూ హ్యాడ్ టు హియర్ అండ్ హియరింగ్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ ది మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ బికాస్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దర్ ఇస్ ఎ క్లోషర్. దర్ ఇస్ నో క్లోషర్ ఫర్ ది ఇయర్. సో ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు హియర్ ది ప్రాపర్ థింగ్. దట్ ఈస్ వై యూ పుట్ వేణు ఫస్ట్. సో కోళెన్ మలియొచ్చున్న ఓరాయెత్తుళ్ళిప్పత్తుం త్రికుడందే ఆరామదన్ విన్ విసా దట్ వన్ విసా ఎట్ దట్ వన్ దట్ ఈస్ వై కుళలిన్ మలియొచ్చున్న. ఈవెన్ కృష్ణాస్ కొడల్ ది మ్యూజిక్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్ బికమ్ సో చీప్ compared to these 10 pasurams, he says. That is why very, very careful. You have to read through that. When Bhagavan says, there's a meaning for all of them. We can find hundreds of different meaning. This is one of them we are trying to tell. Vetra of Cain. Kichaka Venunam. Two different kinds of bamboos. One is the hollow bamboo. The other one is another type of bamboo. Two types of bamboos, they says. And then, కుల్మాణి సూర పాదబాన్. సో క్లస్టర్స్ ఆఫ్ సెలెస్టియల్ ట్రీస్. దెన్ హీ కీప్స్ ఆన్ పుట్టింగ్ సో మెనీ ఆఫ్ దమ్. సో భగవాన్ సేస్ ఎసెన్షియల్ ఇన్ ది 8 శ్లోకాస్, యూ విల్ బి ఫ్రీడ్ ఫ్రమ్ సిన్ఫుల్ రియాక్షన్స్. సిన్ హెస్ ఆల్రెడీ హ్యాపెండ్, ది రియాక్షన్ హ్యాస్ టు కమ్. యూ విల్ బి ఫ్రీడ్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ వన్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ యూ రైజ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది బెడ్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది నైట్ in the early morning, okay? So Brahma Muhurtam, that is where when you get up at that time, fully concentrate your mind with a great attention, because in the morning we always have a sattva buddhi, okay? Rajogunam tamogunam will not come morning. Nobody gets up with anger, at least somewhat cool, okay? Because the body and everything is not full functioning yet. So only when you have the timur power on that, then you get all the ego and everything. So you'll be sattva buddhi. At that time, think of my form. Who am I? Think of who you are. That itself, then everything. Okay? So him and you, the connection, the uravu, that is what he wants to say. So Andar says like that. And think of this lake, the mountain, the caves, the gardens, the cane plants, the bamboo plants, and the celestial trees. Sri Vaikuntham, immediately says. This one connects you to that one. And then you have to cross through several people, Brahma, Shiva, their logams. And the three peaks what I told you, remember that one, gold, silver and iron made of that one. And come back to my Chirabdi, which I really love that place, because from there all the avatarams are basically happening. And then Swedadhiba, which is so brilliant, it's called White Island. Sweda means white. Where Dviba means Thivu. Thivungardhu basically island. And think of the marks what I have. Srivatsam and Kaustubamani. All of them. Think about that. And Vaijayanti garland. Vanamalai. All Kattupushpam. Forest. That is what Krishna is wearing and he is so happy with that one. And Kaumodegi, my club. Sudarsana, the disc what I have. Panjajanya, which is my conch, shankh, and my vahanam, Garuda, and sayanam, and simhasanam, Adisesha, and for all the things, I am nothing without her, that is Shri. Without Shri, I am nothing. So he says, that is everything, all the fortune. I cannot give anything to you without her permission. Okay? Shri Stavam. So that is what he says. Lord Brahma, Narada Muni, Shiva, Prahlada for Bhaktas and everything. Okay? My avatara. Think of my avatara. Matsya, Kurma, Varaha. All of them. So whether Gajendra Moksham has happened after that or before that depends on the Kalpa Vedam. Okay? The sun, the moon, and the fire. And think of Omkara, Pranavam. Purumal says Pranavam. And think of Satyam, the truth. And think of Prakriti. Look, see, we can keep on going what he says, connection to that. Satyam and Prakriti. Satyam always does not change, Prakriti always changing. So he puts one after another. Cows and Brahmanas. Look at the connection. He gives that one, cows and brahmanas and bhakti, devotional service. Cows, brahmanas, devotional service. How much service we have to do to the cows, Krishna tells over here. And Soma and Kashyapa, their wives. They cannot do anything without their wife. Their daughters, Daksha Prajapati, all of them are from there. And then think of Ganges, Saraswati and Yamuna. And think of Airavadam, that elephant, Airavadam, elephant of Indra and Dhruva, how he did the tapas and everything, and the Sapta Rishis. And finally he says, all the Bhagavadas. Think of the Bhagavadas. If you cannot think any of them, think of all your Bhagavadas. That is one of the reasons. The highest Bhagavad you can think of is your Acharya. So, first Smaranai and the last Smaranai has to be Acharya. And in between also everything is Acharya. Smaranti te agilan yenasa mushyande. Smaranti te, those. Smaranti, think of all these things. Agilat, all of them. Yenasa, released. Muchyande, from all the sins. From the Muchyande means is released. Yeah, NSA means all the pavams. So from all the pavams, you will be released. So there's a whole list of them gives, but he made it so simple. He just wants you to think. So Bhagavan is very smart. The first day you think. Second day, I thought about that one, what is in there? You'll go a little more. You go a little more. That is why he says like that one. So my mother used to say that one person was not doing Sandhyavandanam at all at home. His wife wanted to make him to do Sandhyavandanam. So how she can make it, say what she said is one day she give a cup of water and ask him to throw it in the corner. So he was doing that one every day, kapak. And then one day she did not give. Then he was asking. Every day you give a cup of water and ask me to throw, why you didn't give then? When you throw that water, can't you tell two mantras and tell? And throw it out. So it becomes a habit. So that is why we are going to do, start with thinking and then you understand the magnanimity of Bhagavan's compassion. So he approaches far different than Krishna. Krishna approaches at a very high level, like Uddhava. You did prabhati, you should know how to behave. This one, for everybody, Bhagavata, he may not understand a lot of them. He may be carried by so many different forces of life. But we have to bring them, channelize, and make them into the tunnel and put properly into the expressway. That is what he says. So different approach is taken because it is taken from the animal's viewpoint. We are all social animals. That is the reason why Bhagavan did. Very beautiful way of telling. And we can always say, this is Krishna told. Because Vyasa Bhagavan says, it is Krishna. Okay. Ye maam tuvanti anena anga pradibuddhya nishadyaye tesham pranatyaye chaham tadhami vimalam gadim. Ye maam stuvanti anena. Those who offer prayers, worship, puja in this way. In this way means what Bhagavan has given. Okay. So if you start remembering them, slowly you will go through the same route what Bhagavan has given. If you start reading 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, then you do not worry. This is the order in which you will be doing all of them. So you can derive your formula yourself, how to think of all of them and everything. So this way, those who offer prayers to me, anena, in this way. Okay. So finally it comes to the Bhagavadas. If you cannot remember anything, you don't have any time, you say all the Parama Uttama Bhagavadas. Why? Because Swami Desigan said in Guru Parambara Saram, starting from Nirkhedika Kribai, Yadrachika Punyam, Madhusudana Kadaksham, all the way Satvika Sambhashanam. Unless you have the good friends, Satvika friends, you will not go to the Acharya. Because they are the one helping you to go to Acharya. That is why you thank them first and next to the Acharya. Acharya nai, they showed. That is why you have to think about them. So very beautifully he said, Ye maam stuvanti anena, those who offer prayers like this. How? He told already, get up from the bed in the morning, at the end of the night, early morning, concentrate your mind with a great attention. My Swarubam, your Swarubam, next one. My Avataram, Lakshmi. And then think of other kinds of things, Vaisivaikuntham. And then think of the Tripar Kadal. Even if you go through this order, something different, it's not a problem. But you have to think of all of them. So at least some of them. If you cannot do anything, just think of the Bhagavadas. Think of Bhagavan, think of you, think of Bhagavadas. That ends with that. Anga, a Maharaja, he calls here Anga. That is it. Maharaja Indradyumnan. Okay. Pradibuddhya, when you get up, getting up. Nisha Adhyaye, end of the night. When you get up, end of the night. Tesham Prana Adhyaye cha. If you do like that one, Tesham, for them, prana atyaye cha, at the end of their life, Bhagavan says, cha aham, and I will come, aham dadami vimalam kadim, aham dadami, I also confer the eternal unlimited moksham vimalam. Okay, I don't want to go too much, remember this one. Someday we are going to go back to Tirupanalvar's Amalanadipiran. Amalan, Bimalan. That is what he picks over here. Not Amalan, because he is going to do Suddham. But what you are going to get is the Bimalan. That part he is going to tell. Because when you start thinking, you already done this Amalan part of that. Bhagavan already given you that. Because it is a Desa Visesham illatalum, Jnana Visesham has already come. So there is a reason why you put Vimalan here. దట్ యూ కెన్ గో అండ్ సీ ది అమలన్ నిమలన్ నిమలన్ నిన్మలన్. వెన్ వీ డూ దట్ వన్ వీ కెన్ పిక్ దిస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ దట్ గజేంద్ర మోక్షం. వై ఈ సెట్ దిస్ విమలన్? ఓకే, వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ ఈ సేస్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ యూ ది విమల మీన్స్ క్లీన్ ప్యూర్ స్టెయిన్లెస్ వైట్ ప్రిస్టైన్ బ్రైట్ క్లియర్ ఇంపెకబుల్. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ వన్? శ్రీ వైకుంఠం. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. ఓకే, పరమపదం మోక్షం, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ యూ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్. ఓకే, వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ భగవాన్ సేస్ లైక్ దట్ వన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ది భగవాన్స్ ఫలశ్రుతి. సో శుగ బ్రహ్మం టోల్డ్ సంథింగ్ అండ్ భగవాన్ టోల్డ్, బోత్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ దే సెడ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు థింక్ అబౌట్ దిస్ వన్ ఇన్ ది మార్నింగ్. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. యూ కెన్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వన్ ఆల్ ది టైమ్, బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మోర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్ ది మార్నింగ్. కంటిన్యూయింగ్ ఆన్ దట్, శ్రీ సుగౌవాచ ఇత్యాదిశ్య ఋషికేశః ప్రత్మాయ జలజోత్తమం అర్షయన్ విబుధానీగం ఆరురోగ గగాదిబం. ఇది ఆదిశ్య ఋషికేశః. దస్ ఆదిశ్య అడ్వైసింగ్ ఋషికేశం, యు కెనాట్ గెట్ విమలన్, యు కెనాట్ గెట్ అమలన్ అన్లెస్ యు కంట్రోల్ యువర్ ఇంద్రియమ్స్. దట్ ఈస్ వై ఈ యూసెస్ ది వర్డ్ ఋషికేశన్, నాయగన్. నాయగనా నిండ్ర నందగోమనుడయ కోవిల్ కాప్పానే అండర్ సేస్ ది సేమ్ థింగ్. వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్. ఆల్ అవర్ ఆళ్వాస్ ఆచార్యస్ ఋషీస్ దే యూస్ ది పర్టిక్యులర్ వర్డ్ అండ్ యు అండర్స్టాండ్ వై దే యూస్ టు దట్ వన్. ఋషికేశ, ది వన్ హూ కంట్రోల్స్ ది ఇంద్రియం ఈస్ ఆదిశ్య. ఇట్ కెన్ బి అడ్వైసింగ్ కమాండింగ్, యు కెన్ సే దట్ వన్ ఈస్ కమాండింగ్ యూ టు డూ దిస్ వన్. ప్రత్మాయ జలజోత్తమం, బ్లోయింగ్ వెన్ యూ డూయింగ్ ది బ్యూగలింగ్ ది కాన్షియస్ షెల్ జలజోత్తమం. ఓకే, హర్షయన్ విబుధ ఆనీగం ఆరురోగ గగ అదిబదం అదిభం. ఓకే, హర్షయన్, హర్షయన్ మీన్స్ హ్యాపీ, హర్ష మీన్స్ హ్యాపీ, మేకింగ్ హ్యాపీ విబుధ, హూ ఈస్ ఈ మేకింగ్ హ్యాపీ? దేవాస్. ఆనిగం, ది హోల్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ దేవాస్, సొసైటీస్ ఆఫ్ దేవాస్. ఇఫ్ దేవాస్ దే ఆర్ ది టఫ్ వన్ టు ప్లీజ్ బికాస్ దే ఆల్వేస్ ఇన్ డిమాండ్, అట్లీస్ట్ వీఆర్ మచ్ బెటర్. ఇఫ్ దే గివ్ మోక్షం వేసే ఓకే విల్ టేక్ ఇట్ అండ్ దేసే ఐల్ కమ్ ఆఫ్టర్ సమ్ టైమ్. సో దే ఆర్ లైక్ దాట్. సో టు ప్లీజ్ దమ్, సో విబుధ ఆనిగం ఆరురోగ, ఆరురోగ మీన్స్ ఈస్ క్లైమింగ్ అప్ అండ్ గగ అదిబం. గగ మీన్స్ బేసికలీ బర్డ్. ఓకే, అదిబం మీన్స్ కింగ్, రూలర్, ఓనర్, దట్ ఈస్ ది గరుడన్. ఆరురోగ మీన్స్ ఈస్ అసెండెడ్ ఈస్ మౌంటెడ్ ఇన్ టు దట్ వన్. సో ఈ క్లైమ్డ్ అప్ ఆన్ ది కింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది బర్డ్స్ అండ్ దెన్ ఈ వెంట్ వెన్ యూ డిడ్ యూ హ్యాడ్ ఎ బ్లోయింగ్ ది కాంచ్. అనంత ఎప్పుదమే స్టార్టింగ్ అండ్ ఎండింగ్ యు ఆర్ ఆల్వేస్ అట్ ది శంగూధర్. So that is what they do, that Bhagavan gives this advice. Who is this Bhagavan? Rishikesan. And he blew the Panjajanyam, the Shanghu. Okay? So because we cannot end everything with the Chakram. It has to end in a smoothly, Shantam. So Shanghu does everything, that one. So in between they can do all of them, but everybody lived happily ever after. That has to come through only Panjajanyam. So that is why he did very, very particular. That's the reason why they put all of them. And the Devadas were very happy. He climbed on that one. He climbed on the Vedasuribi Garuda. Look at how he starts and how he ends. The Gajendra Stuti, that is what is important. Up to the Gajendra Stuti, we don't care. Okay? Because we, just like us, we're all going like Gajendra with the ego, going and breaking the trees. I'm the king, doing all of them. Well, you need more time. that is why when we do that one, Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa is combined one, Emperumana said. Okay? You have to get hit on that one, Grihastha Ashramam. Then only you understand the greatness of the shade unless you go into the sun. Okay, so similarly, initially whatever he has done, maybe that's okay, that's all prelude. we start the Gajendra Stuti, the first word what he said. Om Pranavam. What is the last phrase he told? Gaga Adibam. Om is the Veda Saram. Gaga Adibam is Veda Surubam. How beautifully connects all of them. So, if you start from there, Vedam, Om Pranavam, which is a single syllable, and you will understand the whole Vedas at the end. And if you go through the Gajendra Moksham, what do you understand? If you start with the Pranavam, you understand the whole Vedas, what it teaches you, you understood already. That is what he has put in bookends. Very, very beautiful way Vyasa Bhagavan has done. So, Idi Srimad Bhagavade Mahapurane Ashtamaskande Gajendra Mokshanam Nama Chaturdodhyayaha. Thus ends the 8th skandam, 4th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavata Mahapurana, titled as Gajendra Goes to the Moksham. Okay, so that will be ending. So we never end that one. It is like the Andadi. We have to go back to the front one. Okay, so we have seen two Palashrutis, one told by Bhagavan, one told by Shugha Brahmam. But actually, there is a Palashruti told by the listener before he listened to this. Look at this guy. Oh, I know that one. If you listen to that, it's great. He didn't know anything at all before that he gave that one. That is the Parikshit Maharaja, he told that one. So we're going to go back to all the way to that one. And then when he starts, okay, this is the Trikudamalai, he starts up to that point, we're going to come now. So we go back into the 8th chapter, 1st Adhyayam. The 1st Adhyayam, 8th chapter, 1st Adhyayam, it starts. 2nd Adhyayam, all the Gajendras troubled will start at that one. 3rd chapter is basically the Gajendra Stuti. 4th Adhyayam, the rescue and the completion of that. The 4 Adhyayams we say. So in the 1st Adhyayam, all the beginnings are about the Manu. All the different Manus. So many different kinds of things are coming. It's telling all of them. So we're going to take 8-1-30. That is the 30th slogan. Sri Sugauvacha is telling, Tatra Vijagye Bhagavan Harinyam Harimedasaha Harir Idi Ahrude Yene Gajendro Mochido Grahat. Tada Abhi. Tada Abhi means during that period. What period? I don't know. He's been telling a story for so many Manus. At that place is Tamasa Manvantaram. Okay? Tamasa or Tamasa, whatever you want to call it. Tamasa Manvantaram. At that time, it's happening. Okay? Tada Abhi. Jagye Bhagavan appeared. Our Lord is appeared. Harinyam Harimedasaha. For Harini and Harimedasa. Harini is the mother, Harimedasa is the father for them. So, the womb of the Harini created by Harimedasa. Okay. Harihi idi. His name is Hari. Ahrudayena Gajendra Mochidaka Grahat. Idi Ahrudayari. Thus, he is called Hari because he is born. Father's name is also Hari. Mother's name is also Hari, Hari Ni, Hari Medasa. So how can I have both of the name? Just shorten that one Hari, you represent both of them. So that is why. Nowadays they keep that name. Okay. So I ask somebody, why you kept your daughter's name Radhika? This somebody else. Radhika. His name is Rangachari. His wife's name is Kamala. R-A-K-A. Radhika. That is what they want to keep out. So there are so many different. That's why we always say Kodai. Goda, when you say Govinda. Govinda cannot have. Koda is the bookends. Govinda, she is squeezing you. That is why கோதை.
கோதை இல்லாம கோவிந்தன்.
ஆ கோதை இல்லாம கோவிந்தன் இல்லை. சோ தே சொல்றாங்க. சோ why I'm telling, that's the name that's given over there, Hari. Also in the Manvantara, Bhagavan Vishnu is born to these people and is called as the Hariyan. And what did he do? He saved the devotee Bhakta called Gajendra from the clutches of the crocodile. So that is what he says, Gajendra Mochitaha Grahat. Gajendra Mochito Grahat. Okay. So Gajendra was released, liberated from the crocodile. That is what it says. So when Sugabrahmam telling about all of them, at that time, he told from Gajendra, and then, oh, who is this Gajendran? I never heard of that. Why don't you tell me that story? That is what Parikshit is going to ask. See, Rajauvacha Bhadarayane Yedatte Shrodum Ichchamahe Vayam Harirya Gajapadim Gragakrastam Amumuchat. Shri Rajauvacha, Shri Rajauvacha. Look at all of them. Hey, Parikshit Maharaja, who is very wealthy. What is the wealth he has got? He has got only 8 more days to live. The wealth what he has got is Bhagavan Kadai Kekar. Okay. Shunadi. Shunadi Nikilan Toshan. Pirati listens to us. That is why it is going. So when we go into the Bhakta Prahladan, he talks about all the different kinds of bhakti. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnoho Smranam Padasevanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasyam Shakyam Atmanivedanam. First one is Shravanam. Okay? Because Parikshit Maharaja is the greatest example of listening. So, Sri Rajauvacha Bhadarayane Edatite is called Bhadarayani actually. So, even though it says Bhadarayane, Bhadarayana is Vyasa Bhagavan, his son Sugabrahma. So he is asking the Sugabrahma, Edat te, this from you, Vayam Shrodum Ichchamahe, we desire to hear. Okay? When Parikshit Maharaja, it's not a one-to-one class. Everybody is listening next to that one. There are so many people, including Narada, some of the Devadas, everybody is listening at that time. We desire to hear. What we want to hear? Gajapadim Gragakrastam. That is his word. That is why Naradaramal used it. Gragakraste Gajendra Ruvadi. Okay. Exactly what he has told, that is what our Acharya used correctly. Okay. Because we give respect to them and use the same words over there. The king of the elephants and the clutches of the crocodile, what has happened? Yadha Amumuchat Harihi. Okay. How he was freed, how he was delivered by Lord Hari. That is what he was asking, that one. So Parikshit Maharaja continues. Now, tell me that, he said. Oh, before you tell me, I'll tell you how great is that one. He never listened. Okay? He knows whatever it is. Okay? He hasn't bought the Google star. He thinks this is going to be twice. Before he thinks like that one. He hasn't seen that place. He has never got married. He thinks all the great things similar to that one. Because he has not realized that. But he is telling. That is because of the Purva Janma and everything. Bhagavad Kadaksham and Acharya's aura. When the aura splits over there, you automatically get before telling some of them. So, Tatkada Sumahat Punyam Dhanyam Swastayanam Shubham Yatra Yatra Uttama Shlogo Bhagavan Kiyade Harihi. One of the beautiful slogans in Bhagavatam. Okay. Tatkada Sumahat Punyam Danyam Swastayanam Shubham Yatra Yatra Uttama Shlogo Bhagavan Kiyade Harihi. Yatra Yatra Uttama Shlogo Bhagavan Kiyade Harihi. Wherever the noble glories Uttama Shloga Yatra Yatra Uttama Shlogo Bhagavan Kiyade Harihi. Bhagavan Hari, about him, all the great uttama shloka, don't start bringing anything else. All the great noble things that glorifies Bhagavan's Swarupa, Rupa, Gunam, all of them, what it will give you? Tatkada, when you hear all of those stories themselves, Punyam, Mahat Punyam, Sumahat Punyam. Look at the words. Punyam, Mahat Punyam, Sumahat Punyam. Punyam, you will get a better wife. You will get a better house. You will get more wealth. Mahat Punyam, you will become Indra. You will become Agni. You will become Brahma. Sumahat Punyam, you will go to moksha. Punyam, Mahat Punyam, Sumahat Punyam. Tat Kada Sumahat Punyam. Listening to the Gajendra Moksham itself will get you moksham. Okay? So don't come and argue from the Ragasatra Saram class. Yes, this will take you to the Acharya and he will do you the Pravatti and then you will go to the moksham. This will pave the way for that one. Okay? Punadi Idi Punyam. That's why what it then is, it tries to cleanse you basically. Pavanam, sacred cleansing. So that is what it basically does. And the future also, by listening to this one, Akami, you will not be doing that one. That is the greatness of this. Danyam, Swastayanam, Subham. What is the wealth? Kaingaryam. Lakshmano, Lakshmi Sambannaha. Okay? So, we are all Kritakrityans. What we really need? Danyam, the only Danyam we need, Kaingaryam. Okay? Swastayanam, Kshemam. Swastayanam means Swasti Ayanam. Swasti Mangalam. Ayanam is circulation. In a circle way, all the Mangalam is coming. What is Mangalam? Kalyanam, Mangalam, Shubham, Avanam says that one. Anything auspicious that makes that to think about Bhagavan, goes to the Bhagavan Sannidhi, talk about him, listen about him, and drop all your tears about him. That is Swasti. And that completes again and again and again and again. That means it makes you, indulge you more and more into Bhagavad Bhakti. That Bhakti is the Sadhya Bhakti for you. Okay, that is Sadhana Bhakti. Danyam Kaingaryam. Swastayanam means basically more Bhakti, Sadhya Bhakti, Shubham. Shubham means it gives you the peace in your heart. I'm not worried about any of this. Deham related stuff. It is going to give happiness to me. It gives happiness to all of them. Because I am like this, it is going to be continuously the auspicious things will happen over here. All of them. So this is what Palashruti told by the King Parikshit. So good, pure, glorious, auspicious, all of them is going to happen before he listens to this one. The story, he tells that one. The next sloka after this one, that is the last sloka in the first adhyayam, Shri Suta Vacha. It's a different character now. Okay. Parikshidaivam Satu Padharayani Prayobavishtena Kadasu Chodidaha Uvacha Vibra Pradinantya Parthivam Mudha Muninam Sadachisma Srinvadham Vibra. Hey Brahmanas, what is happening here? Shugabrahmam is telling the story to Parikshit Maharaja. At that time, there are a lot of people were listening. One of them is Suta Maharishi. Okay? This Suta is basically not in the top varna. Okay? So, the Suta Maharishi later will be telling. When he tells, he gets a shabam and then he dies. When he dies at that time, they are asking, oh, he was telling the Bhagavata Puranam, it is done. How are we going to get? So, they are going to transfer that knowledge to his son, his Suta Junior. So, the Suta Junior gets that one, Suta Pauranigar, and he is the one who is going to tell. When he tells this one, Suta Pauranigar, all the Sanakar and all other rishis are over there. They were listening, all of them. So, Shuga Brahmam is telling Parikshit Maharaja, this guy was listening, who is that? Suthar. And Suthar, something has happened, his son has got the knowledge, that Sutha is telling right now to the Sanakadis, and that is what is written, that is what I have read, I am telling you. That is how one to the other, teller and the listener, that is what's happening, you are saying. Vibra, the Sutha Maharishi is saying, O Brahmanas, Prayoba Vishtena, Prayoba Vishtena Parikshita, impending death. That is what it is. This Parikshita Maharaja was awaiting, was death is knocking on the door. He knows. Okay. Evam Kadasu Chodhidaha. He requested, he was encouraged to tell the stories. Please tell me. That is what he was asking. Sa Padarayani, to that Shuga Brahmam. He was asking that one. Pradinantya Parthivam Mudha. When he told like that one, Pradinantya Shuga Brahmam, hey Parikshit Maharaja, you are a very, very smart person. You are a Jnanavan. You have a very good bhakti. I really, what do you call, cherish, admire yours. That is what he says. Even though he's a Sishyan, you have to respect the bhakti, you are saying. Parthivam, he paid enough respects to him. And with pleasure, he's saying, Muninam sadasisma shrinvadam uvacha. In the assembly of the great sages, rishis and everything, who are very desired to hear Shrinvadam, he is going to tell uvacha. He is telling this one. So, Suta Pauranigar is telling to all the Brahmanas. That is how it is ending that one, the first chapter. Okay. Then it says, Idi Srimad Bhagavate Mahapurane Paramahamsyam Samhidayam Ashtamaskande Pradamodhyayah. First adhyayam ends. And then second adhyayam, this is the Trigudamalai will be starting. That is what we started the first class. So we come into the closing the loop. But we have learnt about this Bhagavadam. Bhagavadam has been written by so many people later on. They added their own creative ways. Even though it is not in the source code, some of them we can really enjoy that. Because all of them gives you bhakti. Narayaniyam does something. Telugu, there is a Bhagavadam is there. And Kodanda Bhagavadam. So there is so many other kinds of things they have written in different people and all of them. Let's look at a couple of things, try to understand how the enjoyment, creative ways of enjoying this one. The first one, Gajendra, in Bhagavadam, it plucked the flower and gave it to Bhagavan, it says. In all other places, they say, every day he was giving this flower to Bhagavan. There's nothing wrong like that, enjoyment. Okay, so Narayaniyam, just like every day the flower was given to that one, every Dashakam when he writes this Narayana Bhattotri, at the end he looks at Guruvayurappan, Krishna. Unless he nods, he cannot go to the next one. So he is talking to him. And Guruvayurappan, Narayaniyam he says, is carrying the lotus flower. And he says, hey, Krishna, on that day, Gajendran gave that one. And you are remembering that one every day you are carrying here. One day Gajendran gave that one, every day you are carrying that. So the Guru Ayurappan carrying the lotus flower tells you the Gajendra Moksham. That is his Anubhavam. Very beautifully it says that one. There is another one in Tamil, what I have done. When Gajendra made that outcry, I cannot, very torturous one. Bhagavan listened to that call and immediately he started, okay? Gajam Dhradum, okay? To protect that elephant, he started that one. So, there are so many things they explained that way at that time what happened. Lakshmi was there, both of them were playing some kind of a game, and his uttariyam is tied to her mundani so that the loser cannot run and everything. At that time Lakshmi is asking, where are you running? He is not putting his padaraksha, he is not having that Vishwaksena to give the hand, he is not looking at the Garuda and everything. He was going fast. Lakshmi is asking, where? He says, ga jam. Okay? Ga, he told in Sri Vaigundam. Before that, he said jam, he came into the earth. That is why jam means jammana vandu nikkara abdingarala. That is the reason why that jam comes up. Why that jammana correcta and artha avula quicka avula alaga vandu nikkaradhu ved jam. And then ga happened over there, jam happens over here. Gajam. That is what he says very beautifully. Somebody's anubhavam on that one. The another one it says, Bhagavan is alangara priyan. Especially Krishna is alangara priyan. All the time alangaram for him. Even though alangaram is not perfect, still he looks very beautiful. So when he left the Vaigundam, he did not look at anything. Just have to rush. He has put the uttariyam to her, and when he rushed to that one, Lakshmi was falling down on that, and he was having that uttariyam tied to his hip. Then he just grabbed something. Uttariyam illana athuki mele podena. He put that one, and he come all the way to Gajendran. And to Gajendran, when he saw the Gajendran was having that so much of pus and blood, he took this uttariyam. He said, tying that one. And why Gajendran got moksham there now? Gajendran was released. But he got moksham because, oh, that is not uttariyam. That was Lakshmi's sari. Lakshmi's sari, when he come accidentally, he brought that one, thought that is his uttariyam. Many times we do that one also. We don't know what we are wearing in the dark. Okay. So that is the reason why he got moksham, because Lakshmi's blessings were there and everything. That is somebody's anubhavam. Look at that one. So all the ornaments and everything were there all. And when he come over here, he came with 8 arms. Okay. Ashta bhujam. That is why Gajendra Raksha Duridam Bhavantam Grahai Divagai Vishayai Vikrishtaha Apara Vigyana Dayana Bhavam Aptam Sadam Ashtabhujam Prabhatyehe Deshyam. Okay. So Ashtabhuja Ashtagam, he says that one. Ashtabhujam. But this guy came so fast, he didn't understand where to put what. If you put a bow on one hand, right side, you have to have the arrow on the left side. Bhagavan has got bow and arrow on the same side. He did not know what to put. If you put the sword in one of them, you put the shield on the other one, you put both of them on the same side. That is a one kavi. He writes that one. So that kind of a speed is going to come. And another one says, Bhagavan looked at that one. He wants to rush and help the Bhagavata so fast. Garuda, you're so slow. He is carrying the Garuda and coming. Who is the Vaganam and who is sitting, kind of thing, is holding the Garuda in his hand and it is coming. This is, some people say, this guy is so fast, he wants to go, he will be running inside the bus. We see that one in the plane. Before the plane lands, they come from the last one to the first, they come close to the gate, to the door. So similar to that one, Bhagavan carried the Garuda, not sitting on the Garuda. This is somebody's anubhavam. Very beautiful, all of them. See, all of them, it basically tells, glorifies only thing, the readiness of Bhagavan to help you. He will help you definitely, but there's a proper time. At the proper time comes, not even a nanosecond he waits. He does that one. So that is the one he wants to do, that one. This has been used by so many of them. Not only that, later on all this Thyagaraja, when he wrote the Kritis, and all other people wrote, they have used Gajendra Moksham, everybody has used, because it's the ultimate example of giving Moksham to the lowest jandu. Okay, not like a human. So that is why it is so great and everything. So now let's look at that one. Coming back into the Gajendra Stuti, where the first sloga what he told, will connect that one. Gajendra is not interested in to save me from this crocodile. The first sloga itself he has told. But we pretended as if we don't know. We gone through all of them. Now when we come back and look at that one in a different view. Sri Gajendra Vaja, Sri Gajendran. Sri Parichit, maybe that's okay. Because he's a Maharaja. This is a Gajendran. He's already losing his life. And he doesn't even have any power to get out of this crocodile. Sri Gajendra Vaja. Om Namo Bhagavate Tasmai Yata Edachidatmakam Purushaya Adibijaya Pareshaya Abhidhimahi. How beautiful he has done. That one slogan is good enough. Look at that one. Bhagavade Om Namo Bhagavade. We said Om Namo. Rest of them, Narayanaya, that is it. So, Ashtaksharam itself is told in the first slogan. Bhagavade to Bhagavan, Sriman Narayana. He started with the Bhagavan, he ends with the Bhagavan in the Stuti. Only when he comes, now he comes, connects them, Agila Guru, Narayana, Bhagavan. Connects that one beautifully. Okay. So, Bhagavan, that is very important. That is the reason why we spend the time going to Sri Vishnu Puranam, and that Bhagavan Padam goes only to him. Who is that guy? Vasudevan, Krishna. Okay. Bhagavade, yada, from which, yetad, this material things, achetanam, chit, all the chetanam, atmagam, belonging, consisting, composed of. Chetanam and Chetanam belongs to you. You are the supports, controls and wants. Sri Bhashyam is starting over here. Okay, beautiful. Purushaya, you are the only Purushan. Because we are all Sri Prayam Idaram Jagathu. That is the reason. Adibijaya, who is the origin. You are the root cause of everything. Because Shritti, Sthiti, Samharam, Anupravesham, Moksha Pradhanam, Shriyaparitvam, everything starts and ends only with you. Nobody else. Very beautiful. Adibijaya, Pareshaya. People can call themselves as Eason. They are not Eason. You are the only one. Tasmai, to that Bhagavan, Abhi Dimahi. Let me do my prayer, my dhyanam, my meditation. What meditation is this one is going to be? This is going to be bhakti, the bhakti yogam, not for the moksham. Sadhya bhakti. Sadhya bhakti is doing that one. So we told on the other day, you can classify any which way you want that one. So it is beautiful to visualize this one. I have done through all these janmas, nothing. Look at that, some rishi came and he has cursed me, now it has happened. Okay? So now if you do the prabhatti, even somebody curse, you will have 1,000 janmas, nothing will happen. You will never have 1,000 janmas. Because there is a more than that one, Bhagavan said, this will be your last janma. Edat degavasanemam tatpadam prapaya swayam. So if you look at the Gajendra Stuti, it is extremely philosophical. All the teaching of the Upanishads. So it is not like a helpless rant of some jandu crying out to the Bhagavan. No, it is not. At that moment, its jnanodayam comes. So that is very important for us. How do we learn from this one? That is the last part of that. Gajendra, and he clutches 1,000 years and he could not do anything. Then he makes this Stuti. How do you connect these two? And you send this to the, he says, Bhagavan, Paresaya, Hadi Bijaya, all those kinds of things. He's having this problem. Why is he doing that one? Bhagavan says, very, very interesting thing. This is the essence of the Gajendra Moksham. The Gajendra, the essence of the Gajendra Moksham is, when there's a problem attacks to you, it comes and attacks. What you have to do? You find a solution where that problem is insignificant. Have to make that problem insignificant. Then only you can do. Otherwise, you will be a slave to that one. Today is Ekadashi. Okay, next Ekadashi is Vaikuntha Ekadashi. Ekadashi. So the problem is basically hunger. How do you attack that one? Oh, remove my hunger. You don't ask that. You look at something else. The way I am making the Bhagavan happy, this is insignificant to me. When the problem attacks, make that one insignificant. Concentrate on higher goal. Concentrate on higher goal. That is what we should be doing. Gajendra Moksham's essence is basically, it tells, when the problem comes, don't look at the solution for that. You look at a bigger one. This becomes a very small, tiny, minuscule one. That is what you have to do. An amazing one. So, if your boss is getting angry in the office, I'm not looking at the boss, how to make him. I'm going to buy the company. If you're going to buy the company, then he is working for you, kind of a thing. Giving a practical example. That is the way you have to look for that one. Okay? So, very beautiful. That is the essence of that one. So, that concludes the Gajendra Moksham series, which we've been enjoying for a long time. Thanks to all the Bhagavadas, especially Hema and Suresh, for every class they have come. Shripriya has come for many of the previous classes and everything. And Jyoti, Jan, and of course Radhika and everything. And all the remote Bhagavadas. So many of them. Some of them I know, some of them I don't know. Because we go through only the email and everything, correspondence, I never seen them. But it is the Bhagavan's Katha we are sharing with that one. All we have to know only is Uttama Bhagavadas. That's all we have to know. We don't have to know anything more than that one. So Krishna says, Udhara sarve evaire, jnani tu atmaiva me madham. Who is Udhara? Udharas are the one, listeners, not tellers. Unless you listen, I would be engaged in something useless. Because of you, I could able to read and think about that one and share the Gajendra Moksham and everything. So, the magnanimous souls are the one who are the receivers, who are the listeners and everything. So, with that, we'll stop today. Kavidharkika Simhaya Kalyana Gudasalini Simade Venkadesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Simade Nikamanta Mahadishigaya Namaha.